we should take a close look at how the Mars 5 Ultra works. I mean, inside, how it is built. Because I had so many questions. How can the build plate know there is no resin? How can the LCD move up and down so many times with no play to get perfect prints? What sort of hinge are they using here? And if you ever need, could you use the screws at the top of the build plate to fine-tune the bed leveling? Also, I could not resist enhancing my printer just a little bit. Well, a bit. And I'll show you how to prepare a build plate for 8 resin calibration tests at once, because it is a bit confusing. I'm Everson, and this is Geek Detour. Two important things. First, I made a few modifications on my printer. It doesn't mean you should modify yours. And second, give this video a like, because it helps a lot. Oh, this is so cute! Oh my god, look, it's a mini drip bed. The Mars 5 Ultra is the little brother of the Saturn 4 Ultra that I already reviewed here in the channel, with three differences. It is smaller, the resolution is a bit higher, and sadly, it doesn't have the flip-up cover. I am still thinking what I could do about it. But the important stuff is the same. Wi-Fi, camera, smart sensors, tilt release, the awesome latch. Just like the Saturn 4 Ultra, I took it out of the box and it printed fine. The construction is mostly metal. I saw a few comments saying that the arm, the mount here, is made of plastic, it's not rigid. But this gap is on purpose. The arm itself, inside, is a sensor, all in metal, with a load cell. Yeah, like a digital scale. But here, a special chip reads it thousands of times per second. It's a lot of functionality just out of subtle variations in pressure. And that's why you should not touch the printer while it calibrates the readings when you start printing. The printer is quite easy to disassemble, and yeah, maybe they could fit everything tighter in a smaller printer. The tilt mechanism is very interesting. It uses two ball bearings and an eccentric axle to move up and down. The stepper motor that does this job is quite beefy, and it makes sense because it needs the strength to peel off every layer. When the printer is turned off, you can push the vet down or up so easily. But when it's turned on, it is impressively strong. It just stays. It is easy to see why. When the vet moves up, this mechanism actually pushes the platform completely against the frame of the printer. It clamps them up. But how does it pivot? I mean, hinges have play, ball bearings have play. This doesn't have any sideways movement. How is it done? I was expecting something exotic, but it is a pair of metal springs, like this, made of steel. It is a solid-state hinge. It doesn't need to flex much, and it always keeps the screen on the same position. And that's exactly the same thing happening inside of this box. We need some vertical movement here, while four flexible metal sheets lock the build plate horizontally. Since we are talking about the build plate, the springs compensate for any height difference. But if you are obsessed, like me, and you wish you could fine-tune the plate like in the good old days, I tried it and it worked. One corner was pressing a bit harder, and I could release the other corners less than a turn, and the grip got more uniform. I marked the position on each screw, took them off to apply a drop of thread locking fluid. You have a couple of minutes to adjust them again, and a few hours later they get fixed. Most of you will never need this, but if you had to and it helped you, let me know in the comments. The camera allows you to record time lapses, which is fun to watch and sometimes useful to understand problems. Sure, quality is not cinematographic, and that's why I added my own tilt sensor. It is completely isolated from the rest of the printer, and every time it tilts down, I can trigger my cameras. Enjoy! You can print 4, 6, and even 8 resin exposure tests at once. And this is how you do it. On the menu, the number 1 is always the longest time, and the number 8 is the shortest. You cannot change that. To make things easy, I recommend you to find a model that has numbers on each piece, so even if you mix them up later, you know which is which. I found a very convenient remix of the cones of calibration with numbers from 1 to 8 and some features on the top. But where should I put them? To be sure, I made some STLs of numbers, so let's see how the calibration tool will print them. The numbers being inverted is correct, but the order is not the one we expected when looking at the menu. It doesn't matter, we just need to change them on the build plate. And when I printed them again, that's all correct. 8 is the quickest exposure and 1 is the longest time. This calibration tool is a godsend thing. I never printed with this white resin before, and yeah, half an hour later, here we have it. 8 tests. Number 4 is my favorite. So easy now. Unless you print some very, very, very weird resin. This is a rubber-like resin from ResiOne. I decided to use the same exposure times again, and I barely got anything on the plate. It was very messed up. It turns out this resin needs a completely different set of values. I thought I would never use the slow mode, but yeah, some resins need it. I created a new profile and I printed the balls again. Only one came out, and the time-lapse shows that I should have used more supports because this resin is incredibly wiggly. See?
Look at this. This is a tricky resin.
It is not for beginners, and to make things worse, it actually deformed my PFA film. The ball is amazing, it is really rubbery, it smells like rubber, and of course, it barely bounces. Now, just for fun, this is that white resin, and this is the rubber resin. My second modification was this rounded edge, and I had the idea after watching my time-lapse. Pay attention, the resin flows down quite easily, but the edges hold some resin that, if the corners were rounded, the resin could completely drip off while it prints and finish clean. Did it work? No, it did not. The Mars 5 Ultra is very easy to use, the best resolution for jewelry makers and to print miniatures. It's an excellent price, and if you like my work, please use my affiliate links. It is the same price for you, and it brings food to my table. And here is my review of the Saturn 4 Ultra, the big brother. And I'll see you on the next video.